Welcome to Tech Arena video review. Today we are going to review SanDisk RediCache 32GB SSD. Many of you are wondering that SSD is a costly solution, but after this review I hope I can change your mind. We are testing the SSD on a machine which has only 1GB RAM and Core 2 Duo processor, and we have installed Windows 8 on it. There are two hard drives in this system. One is 160GB SATA hard drive that is regularly found on online or on local vendors, and second one is RediCache SSD. We'll check out the performance. First we'll check what is the boot time of both the systems. First I'm going to boot on my regular hard drive which has Windows 8 installed on it. This stopwatch will tell us what is the boot time of a regular Windows 8 system installed on 160GB SATA hard drive. The hard drive specification offers 7200 RPM, which is commonly found and which offer us a transfer rate of 1GB per second between different partitions. First let's check out the boot time. This is the old Windows 8. Now the boot time is around 20 to 25 seconds, but still the system is a bit less responsive compared to what I have seen on the SSD. The reason of this low boot time is actual, there is no application or not any antivirus installed on this. Also the system take a time to completely start up, and the right menu appears after a few minutes from the boot time. You can see the system is busy right now. We'll check out some application on this. The response time is around 4 to 5 seconds or 10 seconds for an application. You can see the taps are lagging here. This is what is the common issue we face on our old hardware, and after upgrading to an SSD you can get a very awesome performance. We'll show you the boot time in that also, and about the application responsiveness. I'm going to restart the PC and boot through the SSD. Due to SATA interface it become much easier to use the SSD. As you can see, it is now connected. First we'll check in BIOS whether the SSD is how the SSD is listed. This is a bracket which comes with the SSD that help you to connect the SSD inside the computer. You have to just put the hard disk on the bracket and use the screws or the side set to hook it on the CPU case. Here is the SSD detector, 32GB. If you face any issue with hard drive detection on your old motherboard, you have to go in integrated peripherals and you have to check out on-chip SATA mode. Ensure that it is kept on auto or AHCI, or else the hard drive will not be detected or there will be a disk boot failure error. Now we are booting Windows 8 on the SSD. You can see the response time here. After clicking on the welcome string or the password, the Metro UI loads up instantly. The application are also well responsive here. We'll test out some application on the desktop. This is the response time. You can see how instantly the application opens up when I click on the shortcut icon. Whichever application you are using for photo editing or for video editing, an SSD acts as a powerful source of performance booster. Also, the boot time is reduced to more than 60 to 70% compared to the regular hard drive. This is the SSD, 32GB installed here. Now to use the hard drive and to get a better performance from it, you have to use a software called as Express Cache. The software is provided with the SSD, and there is a manual. There is an activation manual provided with the package. You have to use the serial key init to activate this Express Cache software. To use Express Cache, you have to format your hard drive into two partition. I had provided 10 GB dedicated space for the caching memory. You can see this here. There are two partition here. 20 GB is allotted for the operating system and application, and 10 GB is allotted for Express Cache. This partition does not have any file format. It is just in raw partition. Express Cache scan your partition and locate an empty space. It is just like a Windows Ready Boost technology, but much more better than it. With the help of Express Cache, your application performance is more improved, and it keeps on recording all the instructions whatever you are using. And when you are accessing your application, the performance will be 4 times faster compared to the regular usage. Now you can see here the total cache size is listed as 10 GB. You can allot this size as per your usage. You can put it 4 GB or 3 GB or whatever your requirement is. You have to enable caching here. As I said before, you have to activate the product before, or else it will not work. This is a small cache monitor here that tells you about your current activity. After starting this application, the performance is more improved and much better. For resource intensive application, Express Cache works very well. You can see the performance of Windows 8 is drastically changed compared to the one that I was using on my regular hard drive. Let's check out the transfer rate here. We'll copy some folders from the internal hard drive to the existing SSD. At minimum scale, the SSD offers you a 60 to 70 MB of data transfer speed among the partition. I'm transferring the data from my old hard drive to this new one, and I'm getting it around 60 MB per second. The total size of data is around 4 GB. And the same rate when we do internally inside the SSD, it is much faster. The SSD is capable of giving you more than 400 Mbps of data transfer speed if it is used inside the partition among the folders. SanDisk ReadyCache SSD is an optimum solution for getting a performance in your system without going for heavy upgrades. I have shown already that I am using only 1 GB of RAM, and still on that Windows 8 is working very well. There is no requirement for a dedicated video memory or to add a heavy processor. For gaming PC and for professional work, SanDisk ReadyCache is an optimum solution. 32 GB may not be enough for using some for video editing or photo editing software, but you can also get a variant of 120 GB or higher on this. Thank you. Visit techirena.in.